Good morning to all. Today's class is about dental considerations in respiratory diseases. Okay. Introduction. Respiratory system. Other name is oxygen delivery system. Introduction is respiratory system is the set of oxygen, set of organs that allows a person to breathe and exchange oxygen and carbon dioxide throughout the body. The integrated system of organs involved in the intake and exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide between the body and the environment, and including the nasal passages, larynx, trachea, bronchial tubes and lungs. Okay. Respiratory system performs two major tasks. Okay. First, external respiration. Second one, internal respiration. What is external respiration? External respiration is exchanging air between the body and the outside environment is known as external respiration. Okay. Next, internal respiration. Internal respiration is bringing oxygen to the cells and removing carbon dioxide from the referred to as internal respiration. This is the introduction of oxygen delivered system or respiratory system. Okay. Next. These are the contents of respiratory diseases. Okay. Upper airway infections, lower airway infections, clinical findings, oral manifestations, guidelines for oral health care, chair positions of respiratory patients, airway maintenance and gaseous administration, adverse effects and interactions, and infection control. These are the contents. Okay. Next. This is the human respiratory system. These are upper airway respiratory system. Okay. These parts are lower respiratory system. What are the parts of lower respiratory system? Trachea, bronchial, lungs, heart, ribs. Okay. Lower part of respiratory system, it contains trachea. Okay. This is the trachea. See here. Trachea. Okay. Trachea divides into left and right bronchus. Okay. These are the bronchus. Left and right and left bronchus. Okay. Next. Bronchus. Each bronchus divide into bronchioles within lungs. Okay. Each bronchiole contains numerous alveoli where exchange of gases takes place. This is the alveoli. Okay. The lungs are protected by rib cage. This is rib cage. Here, lungs are protected by rib cage. Okay. This is rib muscle. These are the lungs. Okay, this is the human respiratory system. Normal human respiratory system picture. Okay, next. This is alveoli. Okay, what is alveolus? The exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide occurs. Oxygen and carbon dioxide occurs between air and your blood. Okay, it covering each alveolus is a whole network of little blood vessels called capillaries. Okay. Next, there are many respiratory diseases. For easy understanding and remembering, they are divided into upper airway infections, lower airway infections. Okay, under upper airway infections is common cold, pharyngitis, allergic rhinitis, laryngitis, sinusitis, tracheobronchitis, influenza, herpangina, acute obstructive laryngotracheobronchitis, viral upper respiratory infections. Okay, these are the upper airway infections. Next, lower airway infections: bronchitis, pneumonia, bronchiolitis, asthma, COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, emphysema, granulomatous lung disorders, cystic fibrosis, pulmonary embolism, pulmonary neoplasm, occupational lung disorders. These are the under lower airway infections. Next, normal airway. Okay, this is the normal cross sectional of bronchiole. Okay, normal cross section. Okay, in asthma patients, the airway wall thickness due to inflamed. Okay, here, because of that, the airway becomes narrow. On top of that, there will be secretion of mucus. Okay, there will be secretion of mucus, which further narrows the airway. So, because of this, patients will have difficulty in breathing. Okay. This is normal airway. These are the during asthma symptoms. Asthma patients with breathing is difficult. Okay. See here, airway wall. Here, thickened airway wall. This is mucus. Okay. This is normal muscle airway wall. Okay, these are the lungs. Okay, next, location of lungs and bronchial tubes. Okay, in bronchitis patients. Okay, here the windpipe, other name trachea or windpipe. This is the bronchial tube, right lungs. These are the bronchial tube with bronchitis. Okay, in bronchitis there is less thickening of wall compared to wall of asthmatic patients. but there is increased amount of mucus secretion that narrows the bronchial tube. Okay, bronchial tube wall. Okay, next, normal lungs, COPD patients. Here the COPD, these are the normal lungs, these are the COPD patients' lungs. Okay, COPD patients, the shape of the bronchioles also altered in COPD patients. The walls of alveoli, which are also called A sacs, will destroy and communicate with the adjacent alveoli, okay, forming large alveoli. Okay, forming the large alveoli. Here they destroy the shapes. This is the alveoli. Here the alveoli air sacs, here destroyed, forming fewer larger alveoli. Okay, because of this larger alveoli, the less exchange of gases takes place here. Okay, this is the COPD patients. This is very important for you your exams. Okay, this is 4 marks. COPD is 2 marks or 4 marks question in your exams. Clinical findings. Next, clinical findings of respiratory diseases patients. Okay, clinical findings are cough, breathlessness. Medical term, dyspnea means breathlessness. Sputum, expectorated blood. Hemoptysis means expectorated blood. In medical terms, hemoptysis. Okay, wheeze, chest pain, and rhinorrhea, nasal congestion, sneezing, headache, pruritus, oropharyngeal irritation, lymphadenopathy, clubbing, cyanosis, fever, malaise, fatigue. Okay, these are the clinical findings of respiratory diseases. Okay, clubbing is 2 marks question. Okay, cyanosis, clubbing, these are the dyspnea, hemoptysis, all are 2 marks questions. Okay, next, oral manifestations in upper respiratory diseases. Okay, what are the oral manifestations in upper respiratory diseases? Viral infections, herpangina, sinusitis. Okay, viral infections can cause multiple ulcerations of oral mucosa. Okay, herpangina can cause small discrete vesicles. See here, small discrete vesicles of posterior oral cavity and pharynx. Sinusitis can cause pain resembling toothache. Okay, this is the posterior aspect, discrete small vesicles. Okay, and ulcers also here. Okay, these are the oral manifestations in upper respiratory tract diseases. Next, oral manifestations in lower respiratory tract diseases or asthma, COPD, emphysema, granulomatous diseases. Okay, lower respiratory tract diseases are very important in students. Okay, in students exams. Okay, asthma. Asthma patients, corticosteroid inhalants patients can cause acute pseudomembranous candidiasis. Okay, next, COPD. And then, what is COPD? Chronic, full form is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Can cause smokers, melanosis, nicotine stomatitis, dysplastic changes of oral mucosa. Okay, here second picture is the smoker's melanosis. This is the cord-like appearance. This is candidiasis. Okay, emphysema. Emphysema can cause xerostomia due to mouth breathing. Okay, this is the granulomatous disease. They can cause mucosal ulcerations. See the picture. Mucosal ulcerations, cervical lymphadenopathy. Okay, granulomatous diseases is very important for your exams in asking you for 4 marks or essay question or 2 marks. Okay. Thank you. Okay. Next class I will tell guidelines, chair positions, airway maintenance, adverse effects, infection control. We will continue in next class. Okay. Thank you.